evening, New Canaan High School. Welcome back to this edition of the Morning Announcements, Homebound. I'm Fiona Stevens. That's right, this is not a joke. I'll be your host for today. I figured with weather covered, it was about time I took a stab at the news, so let's get this party started. We just finished our third week of online learning, and you guys have been doing a great job of adjusting to the new school schedule. As you know, we are currently slated to return to school on April 20th, so we still have a couple more weeks ahead of us. But for today, let's talk about some coronavirus updates, information regarding junior appointments, and some fun activities to do during quarantine. But before all that, let's send it over to Principal Egan, who has a very special message for all of you on Bring Your Pet to School Day.
Hi, this is Harry and Sally. If I could get them, say hi, Harry. Hi, Sally. Say hi, Sally. 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 Say hi. Say hi. It's not about the ball. It's not about the ball.
Thanks, Principal Egan. You've got yourself some cute dogs there. I tried to get my cat Lana to be my co-host, but unfortunately, she's a bit of a diva. Well, anyway, on to news that's been concerning, well, everyone, the coronavirus. As I'm sure you know, Director of Emergency Management Mike Handler has been sharing daily, or what feels like hourly, updates on the coronavirus and stressing the importance of social distancing. If you are experiencing any symptoms, such as fever, dry cough, or stomach aches, etc., please do yourself and those around you the favor of filling out the necessary paperwork in order to get tested. And in another effort to keep everyone safe, the town has closed all parks to ensure that quarantine guidelines are being followed. Remember, we can all get through this together by working together. So remember to stay safe, stay inside, and wash your hands. With all of this online learning, Principal Egan has decided to change the final day of the third quarter. Instead of it being today, it will be pushed back to Thursday, April 9th, so that teachers can continue to bombard you through Zoom, finish up their grades, and give you slackers, hardworking students, the grades you all deserve. And in AP news, as Harvey mentioned last week, all AP tests will be taken online at home and only be using material taught before early March. The College Board will be releasing all the detailed information today, so please make sure to check your emails. And remember, just because the tests are at home now does not mean you should not start preparing now. If you have any question, don't hesitate to email your AP teacher or counselor. Now, juniors, something we've all discussed before, your junior appointments are still happening. Most likely, you guys will be meeting through Zoom or Google Meet to contact your counselors about life after NCHS. And luckily for you guys, Mr. Willett has prepared a video to share some tips and tricks to prepare for your appointment. Mr. Willett?
Hi, everyone. I hope you're doing well. Oh, hi, Kermit. Everyone, this is Kermit the Frog.
Mr. Willett, who are you talking to?
Well, Kermit, I'm talking to all the New Canaan High School students. And here are some things you can do to make your junior college meeting go smoothly. Number one, pick a good location. You want a nice backdrop. Number two, make sure your mom and dad are invited to the meeting and let them know they're on camera. Number three, prepare any questions that you have and be ready. Number four, remember, you're not in this alone. You've got your family and you got your friends. And we're here to help. So remember, stay safe and be well.
Thanks, Mr. Willett. Fortunately, I am a senior, so I only have to worry about going to college. But as I'm sure most of you know, since colleges have canceled their campus tours, they are offering virtual tours in their stead. Also, juniors, during your appointments, counselors will be discussing potential testing options for the SAT and ACT. Juniors, I know this can be an extremely stressful time, but I also remember that the NCHS counseling staff is always here for you, even in these trying times. Speaking of questions, you all must be asking yourself what on earth to do since everyone is pretty much stuck inside like I am. Luckily for us, we have NCTV reporter Alex Meitzer with some fun suggestions for activities to do inside. Alex?
Well, thanks, Fiona. That's exactly right. I'm here to tell the students at NCHS what they can do while they're stuck at home. And remember, guys, as fun as it might be to play a video game or a board game or read a book, you can always go outside for some fresh air as well.
Thanks, Alex. I've been pretty bored these past few weeks, so I'll be sure to try some of those out. Now, NCHS, it's time for some news quick hits. Let's start off by giving some love to the juniors. Since the SATs and ACTs have been canceled, some colleges are making test scores optional for your transcripts. And while it's still a good idea to take them, I think it would be best for you to double check the colleges you're applying to see if they're still requiring your scores or not. And of course, double check with your parents as well. Seniors, as you've no doubt probably heard, but the NCHS senior internship program has unfortunately been suspended, as it would be too difficult for businesses to get back on their feet and take on students as well. And finally, spring break is not looking to be those 10 days as we had hoped for, as this past Monday, the Board of Education decided instead to have a 4-day weekend starting on February 10th to last through the Monday, 3 days of school, then followed up by a 3-day weekend starting on February 17th to last through the 19th. And if you're wondering where those 3 missing vacation days went, don't worry, we'll either see them in May or tag them on to the end of June and end school early. So let's look on the bright side here, folks. 7-day break is better than no break at all. Whew. Well, with all of that out of the way, I guess you know what time it is. Let's send it over to Dylan Pescatore, who's been working tirelessly to find some sports news to report.
Thank you, Fiona. It's been tough trying to put together a sports segment for you guys, but today I'll do my best. Good morning, NCHS. I'm Dylan Pescatore, and this is your Rams Sports Report. Throughout the last few weeks, we put together a top 10 list of our favorite games from the winter sports season. Ian gave you games 10-6 last week, so I'll take games 5-1 and wrap it up today. Number 5 takes us to the hardwood, where girls basketball took down Greenwich earlier in the season. Junior Quinn McKiernan dropped 11 points, and senior Katie Dunn dropped 9. Number 4 takes us to the ice, where girls hockey took down Fairfield Co-op, a team of Ward and Ludlow players, in their FCAC semifinal game. Jade Lowe had a hat trick in that one. The girls ended up winning 5-0. Number 3 takes us back to basketball, where the boys faced Fairfield Ward earlier in the season, and they took them down 58-53 in overtime. Alex Gibbons with 22 points of his own in that one. Number 2 takes us back to the rink. Boys hockey, they beat Ridgefield in the FCAC semifinal after a back-and-forth game and ended up going to double overtime, and Shane Mettler, the freshman, had the winner in that one. Number 1, the game you guys have all been waiting for. It's still boys hockey when they won the FCAC championship. Spoiler alert, we'll get highlights for you right now. We didn't get to show you guys that when we were in studio, but you get to see him right now. I'm on the call, so enjoy.
Do it. Puck drop is done. Ariane wins it, and now down the right side comes Sam Erickson. Takes the first shot. It's deflected into the net. Aiden Gamble. Right side corner. Back out point. Bettler bomb. Save. Rebound. A save. A score.
Okay, that's big.
Justin Wheatfeld. Only 33 into the game. Wheatfeld, 1-0. Wheatfeld looks for a power move on his backhand. It gets taken down. Throws it on net. It goes behind. Now back in front, McDaniss looks for a shot, and it finds its way in!
Boom.
It's Nick McDaniss, 2-0. Turns it over, and now Dean on a rush. Johnson back, Griffin Dean tries to make a move, shoots, saved by
score!
It's in! Griffin Dean on the shorthanded chance! 3-0 Rams! Now back to the middle, Dyer fans on it, and now Dean will start a rush. Griffin Dean scored 1 shorthanded goal already. Takes the shot.
Oh, he scored again.
Griffin Dean, 2 shorthanded goals. 4-1.
Wow.
The clock goes off. New Canaan is your 2020 FCAC champions.
Wow.
What a game that was, and what a season it was for that boys hockey team and really all teams in their winter campaigns at New Canaan High School. Hopefully we get more special moments like those in the spring season. Finally, we have some commitments to announce. Liam Griffith, smart guy, is heading over to Harvard. He's going to play lacrosse over there. Chris Kerr to MIT, not that bad as well. He's going to go play football over there. Ryan Lytle is going to Babson, NCTV's own, to continue his track and cross-country career. Well, that's it for me, NCHS. It's been a great time giving you the sports from my nice condo over here in Florida. Everyone stay safe and go out and exercise a little bit 6 feet away from everybody else. Back to you guys at the desk.
Thanks, Dylan, and congrats to Liam, Chris, and Ryan. That's amazing. Well, the weather I promised last weekend pulled through. However, I am looking forward to some warmer temperatures. So to see what's in store, let's send it over to McKenna Usher for the latest. McKenna?
Well, Fiona, this week's weather has been pretty chilly, but good news, it looks like next week will be a bit warmer. What's up, NCHS? I'm McKenna Usher, here to give you this weekend's weather. We woke up this morning to temperatures in the low 40s, accompanied by some showers, but not to worry, because the rain will eventually go away as we go into the afternoon, and you can expect temps to warm up to the low 50s. It's been pretty windy today, so hopefully this wind sweeps away COVID-19. Remember, if you decide to go out for a walk, make sure you bring a light jacket. Now, moving on to Saturday, it's going to be even warmer. You probably won't even need that jacket because temperatures are going to eventually rise into the high 50s with a low in only the mid 40s. Saturday is definitely going to feel more like a spring day with partly cloudy skies, so make the most of it by spending some time outside with your family or your pets. On Sunday, temperatures are going to creep up a bit with a high once again in the high 50s and a low in the mid 40s. The skies are expected to be pretty cloudy, but don't worry guys because it will still be warm enough to head outside. Now, looking into next week, temps are going to finally warm up a bit, most days being in the high 50s and some days even hitting the low 60s. Only bad thing though, Fiona, looks like the rain will arrive towards the end of the week. Have a nice weekend, everyone.
Thanks, McKenna. Glad to hear things are finally starting to heat up. I've been trying to go outside and now with warmer weather on the way, I guess I have no choice. Now, before we go, we'd like to wish a very happy birthday to Connor Markey, Charlie Mayhos, Giovanni Montano, and Mr. Cebulski's son, Sebastian. Happy birthday, buddy. We hope you and everyone else enjoys their weekend of social distancing and quarantine fun. And don't forget to check out and subscribe to our YouTube channel. We leave you now with a video by Harvey Dupluck on what he's been doing during quarantine. This has been Fiona Stevens. Have a great weekend, everyone, and we'll see you next week.
17 years I've waited for this opportunity. This opportunity to prove to the world that I can do it. To prove to myself that I can do it. I've been training harder than ever. I'm in this gym 12 hours a day, 8 days a week. I've ran on that treadmill so many times that I'm faster than bloody Usain. I've hit the heavy bag so many times that I can outbox Mayweather himself because this is the only thing that matters to me. I've gone on a diet to beat all diets. It's awful. I think I'm ready. No, I know I'm ready.